A denial of service is an attack on the availability of IT resources. The resources could be servers, computers, network devices, software applications, websites, the list goes on. Now, the attack can prevent availability of IT resources to legitimate users and could be for a short duration or for a long duration. Now, in denial of service attack, attackers flood the target with illegitimate or unsolicited requests or heavy traffic. They do this to overload the resources of the target, or rather what I would call the victim. Now, here's the question that we all have to think about. What are the major things the denial of service attacks can target?
Now, they can target the network bandwidth or connectivity. Now, bandwidth attacks feed the network with a high volume of traffic, so high that the network could get choked. Have you experienced any slow network speeds? Now, it could have been caused by a denial of service attack. So, here we go. Let's go ahead and look at connectivity attacks. Now, normally these attacks overload the target computer with a huge number of connection requests. Now, that is more requests being sent to the computer than it can handle. The requests will consume almost all available CPU and memory resources. They leave very little or no resources for legitimate users. Okay, let me illustrate this for you. Consider we have a company that takes orders over the phone and delivers burgers. Let's say that they have two phone lines to receive orders. Remember, two phone lines, okay? Suppose a person with malicious intent figures out a mechanism to block one line all the time and keeps the other phone busy most of the time during business hours. The first phone line is not available at all to the customers. The second one is only partially available. So the service through the first phone is fully denied, and the service through the second one is partially denied. Customers would have to try to order once, twice, or three times. If they continue to get busy signal, what would they do? Obviously, they're going to look for another company to get their dinner, at least for that day. Now, if they continue to experience this problem, then they'd obviously move to another company permanently. The burger company is partially available. It may not even know that one of its lines is blocked, and the other one is also more or less blocked. Now, they lost their reputation, customers, and business. Unless they figure out why this has happened, then they'll never be able to recover from the problem. They may require expertise or help from a telephone company or an expert to figure out what's really happened. Now, as an example, they may have to use a caller ID machine to identify the malicious caller so that they can block that number from disrupting the business. Or they may have to have an EPABX telephone exchange to monitor the calls. Now, they may have to check if their connection from the telephone junction box to their office is intact. They may have to do quite a lot of small or big things to ascertain the root cause of the issue. Only then can they figure out what to do. Now, it could be a quick fix or a short-term solution so that the business can continue. Then they would have to work out a long-term strategy. Denial of service attacks work in a similar way. Now, as we said earlier, the objective of the attacker may be to disrupt the business. Now, what we're saying is that the intent could be malicious. It could be to reduce the availability of the company's IT service and then impact their services. So the attacker may do it using a single machine. Now, he may use many compromised computers to cripple a target computer. Even your computer could be used as an agent. Now, we'll see how in just a little bit later.
So, shortly, you will see how to identify symptoms of a denial of service attack. Mm-hmm. Now, you will also see how you may face such an attack and how you may, maybe more importantly, prevent it, right? Take preventative measures to counterattack. Mm-hmm. Now, with technology changing fast and becoming more sophisticated, attackers, like we mentioned, are also becoming more and more sophisticated and more lethal at the same time.
That's right.
Now, you may have to keep pace with them to protect yourself. You may not avoid all attacks, but you can definitely avoid many.
That's right.